Now everyone's really excited, ready to go. Is that better? Turn it up, turn it up. Hey, we need to thank Steve Ellis and his team. First year organizer. I mean, this is a contest we've been on 4 years, but really, he made sure it didn't rain at all this weekend. It really takes a good organizer to have a good contest. Another good contest is the first weekend of October that Scott Smith is organizing in Rome, Georgia. That is something unique in the state of Georgia. It is a back-to-back contest, pro and backyard. So, cook teams, right? Think about this. You go in there, you cook and turn in meat on Saturday, and you start all over, and you do it again, and you turn in meat on Sunday. So, you set up only one time, I would say it's something you need to look into. First week in October, go to kcbs.us. kcbs.us. Again, Stephen, thank you for everything you did.
Yes, sir.
Hey, Stephen!
All right, so welcome! Is everybody having a good time?
That was sad.
I said, are you having a good time? Okay, so my name is Stephen Ellis. I'm on the Gainesville JC's board of directors, and on behalf of the Gainesville JC's, I just want to welcome you, if you're not from Gainesville, to our perfect little town here in Hall County, Georgia. And I am the contest organizer, obviously, for the Hoggin' on the Deer barbecue competition that we have. Louder. More cowbell, they screamed, and we were dressed. All right, so a few housekeeping items that we'd like to get out of the way. Firstly, I actually would like to give a big thank you to two different entities that we have partnered with for 2 years now on what I would consider a growing and very successful event named Laurel Summerfest in its second annual year. The first, obviously, is Hall County Government, and two people who have been very integral in that would be Mr. Marty Nix and Miss Mrs. Katie Crumley. Can I get a round of applause for those two people and everyone connected with them, please? Thank you. Secondly, of course, we're in their hometown right now here inside the park because this is their park. The second entity is obviously the Hall County Parks and Leisure Services, and Mr. Mike Little and Mrs. Shanda Sexton have been phenomenal to work beside, and we thank them for their services and helping us get this thing set up. Next, over here, this tent that was right in front of the backside of the People's Choice Pavilion, where you have a short little lady that is waving. Thank you. We have a video of our Gut Check program, which is one of the charities that we as the JCs put on every year. And the money that is collected on our end, some of it goes to Gut Check. If you'd like to check out that video to see what the Gut Check is all about, then please go over sometime and check out the video there. The other charity that we do is called Empty Stocking Fund, and it is a phenomenal program just like Gut Check, and we provide more than 200 kids and pretty much basically their families by extension Christmas presents that those kids otherwise would not have spread out through Hall County. So thank you for showing up. Your participation helps us provide for that program and for Gut Check. We also have a raffle going on under that tent. It would be, I believe, you're buying a chance to win on a lottery ticket or something. If you want more info, see the waving bald-headed guy who has his bald head covered up with a hat, Lincoln Griffin. Okay, next thing. See if I can keep it together. So, one of the things that we did this year was bring in a lot more of the community involvement into this event in particular. So we what we've really done this year is provided a better a better way for people to connect with public service members. And some of you may have seen and heard and witnessed and tasted and smelled and probably ate some, I'm sure, the public safety teams that have been cooking here, and I want to give them a big round of applause for their participation. It's Hall County Sheriff's Office, Hall County Fire Services for station number 2 representing that team. You also have Gainesville City Police Department and Gainesville City Fire Department. Give them a big round of applause. All right. Now, we will probably go ahead and get their trophies out of the way because I know they are just itching to see who has the bragging rights for the next year. So, without further ado, if you'll give me just one moment to get my sheet out.
Hey, Matt.
So the way that the competition worked this year for them was the firefighters were going against the firefighters. So it was literally a head-to-head match between Hall County versus Gainesville, because you know they just really don't like to work together. They love competing. That's what we do in Gainesville. And I think that it shows based on the scores, but as far as the fire teams go, let me have both of them come up with some representatives if they are here in the crowd. None of them? Come on, come on. Don't be scared. All right, Scott. I see another one coming. Let me go ahead and get Hall County Fire Services Station number 2 representatives up here, and we will then announce the winner between the head-to-head match. So, with an overall score of 114 out of a possible of 130 total points between their People's Choice pork butts and their chicken wing eating judging contest, your winner of the first annual public service member cook-off is Gainesville City Fire Department. Thank you guys for your service. We love you. Thanks for what you do for our community, keeping us safe. Now, police teams. Hall County Sheriff's Office, where are you, Gary? I know you're here. Let me get Hall County Sheriff's Office and Gainesville City Police, please. Gary was scared. He was scared.
Thank y'all for what you do. Congratulations.
So, we are now ready to find out who the first winner of this year's first annual public safety cook-off is between the police officers of Hall County and Gainesville. And with a nearly perfect score, close anyways, 125.875 as a total, your winners, Hall County Sheriff's Office!
Good job, Matt.
Hey, guys. Appreciate it.
All right. Next on the pecking list. This year we also brought up a very special family named the Wyatt family. And they have a daughter named Rachel who is sitting over here in this white shirt with this pretty face, throwing up the peace sign. Rachel is 10 years old, and she has AL leukemia. And when I came across this story from one of our teams that was coming up this year called the Water Hogs, their team captain Brian Darby, which is also sitting close by with this family, we shared about a 2-hour long conversation with many, many tears. And it was just one of those conversations that really tore at your heart. So I basically thought we as the Gainesville JCs needed to do what we could if we had the opportunity to be like a Make-A-Wish Foundation to bring...
Dog!
Get the next one! Grab the next one!
Turn that switch back on, man!
Grab the one beside you!
Steve, grab the other mic! It's charged!
Thinking area!
I knew Gainesville police was trying to sabotage us after their loss.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Test.
There you go.
Alrighty. Back to it. So, like I was saying, if the Gainesville JCs ever gets an opportunity to do something, to be like Make-A-Wish, we need to do that. So, I contacted Deborah, her mother, and asked if Rachel felt like it, would they be willing to come up if we brought them up, basically all expenses paid? What would it take to get her up? And there was no hesitation. Rachel was so excited about it, she wanted to come up on Thursday night when teams really are just starting to roll in because she was so excited. So we're just very, very, very excited to have her here. And when we go and announce the overall, we're going to bring Rachel up so that let's even try and see if we can get every team after we call our overall teams up. Let's after... The announcement for that is, let's get a picture with all of our teams and Rachel and their family up here, if at all possible. So, thank you for coming, Rachel. Thank you. So, if I can get this thing, since they blew in the wind. All right, pro. You want me to start backyard day? Okay, so we're going to go backyard first. And the way that this is going to go this year is we're going to call up all the teams who have placed for payment and award. And the wind really hates me. Yeah, geez. Okay. So we're going backyard chicken. We're going to go ahead and call up the following teams. Yeah, right here. Can we get Dixie Mountain Barbecue to come up, please? Can we get Sergeant Barker's Smoking Hot BBQ to come up, please?
Come on,
let me get Poppin' Pig's BBQ come on, to come up here, please. Water Hogs BBQ, please. Saucy Swine and Bovine. DDQ. K-Town Daddy's BBQ. We Be Smokin'. Millbilly's Barbecue. Garden Valley Smokers. Now in 10th place, Dixie Mountain BBQ. In your 9th place, we've got Poppin' Pigs BBQ. In 8th place, we've got Water Hogs BBQ. In 7th place, we've got DDQ. In 6th place, we have K-Town Daddy's BBQ. And in 5th place, Millbilly's Barbecue. 4th place, Sergeant Barker's Smokin' Hot BBQ. Now, your top three for the Backyard Chicken. In 3rd place, We Be Smokin'.
What's that, Jack?
Pictures with the trophy. In 2nd place, Garden Valley Smokers.
All right.
And in 1st place, Saucy Swine and Bovine. Thank you, guys. Thank you.
Come on, Howdy Q. Come on, Howdy Q.
Okay. Top 10 in backyard ribs. Let me get smoke 'em if you got 'em. DDQ. Sergeant Barker Smokin' Hot BBQ. Saucy Swine and Bovine. Oinkalicious. Let me get pork skis. JJ's Q4U. Bingin' on BBQ. Blakers BBQ. And Tire Toters BBQ. In 10th place, smoke 'em if you got 'em. In 9th place, Saucy Swine and Bovine. In 8th place, Sergeant Barker's Smokin' Hot BBQ. In 7th place, Oinkalicious. In 6th place, Bingin' on BBQ. In 5th place, Tire Toters BBQ. In 4th place, DDQ. In 3rd place, Blakers BBQ. In 2nd place, Portskis.
All right.
Turn around for your picture, Stan. And obviously now in 1st place, Mr. Jason Williams with JJ's Q4U.
Thank you.
Thank you, team. Backyard pork category. Let me get pork and butts. Let me get Tire Toters BBQ. Let me get DDQ. Let me get pork skis to come on back up. We be smoking. Butt rubbing BBQ. Dixie Mountain BBQ. Saucy Swine and Bovine. Oinkalicious. And two brothers from another mother. In 10th place, DDQ. In 9th place, Dixie Mountain Barbecue. In 8th place, Oinkalicious. 7th place, Tire Toters BBQ. In 6th place, We Be Smoking. In 5th place, Butt Rubbin' BBQ. In 4th place, Pork and Butts. In 3rd place, two brothers from another mother. In 2nd place, Portskis. And in last but not least, 1st place, Saucy Swine and Bovine. Now we're going to do the top 5 overall on your backyard. Let me get DDQ. Let me get Pork and Butts. Let me get Saucy Swine and Bovine. Let me get Pork Skis. And let me get JJ's Q for you. In 5th place overall for the backyard, Pork and Butts. In 4th place, JJ's Q for you. In 3rd place, DDQ. In 2nd place, Porpskins. And your grand in your backyard, Saucy Swine and Bovine. Congratulations. Candy, wherever you are, happy birthday. You are now 8 years old. Pro category, we're going with chicken. Top 10, no random order. Rolling competition Q. Atlanta BBQ store. Bubba Q. Moyer's Competition Barbecue Team. Chattahoochee Q. Contagious Q. Big Daddy Q. Sauced Barbecue. Shade Tree Barbecue. And finally, Templar Temptations. Yeah. So in 10th place, we've got Bubba Q. In 9th place, Big Daddy Q. 8th place, Atlanta BBQ Store. 7th place, Templar Temptations. 6th place, Roland Competition Q. 5th place, Shade Tree Barbecue. 4th place, Moyer's Competition Barbecue Team. In 3rd place, Contagious Q. And in 2nd place, Sauced BBQ. And with a perfect 180 score, Chattahoochee Q! Somebody come get this pin. Rib category. Let me get Pickin' Porkers, Heavenly Hogs, Moyer's Competition Barbecue, The Pit Crew Georgia, Bubba Q, Chattahoochee Q, Old Plantation Barbecue, Uncle Kenny's BBQ, Hickory Prime.
Tina.
Sauced BBQ. Soused. Now in 10th place, Moyer's Competition Barbecue Team. Hickory Prime coming in 9th place. 8th place, Old Plantation Barbecue. 7th place, Heavenly Hogs, Georgia. And in 6th place, Sauced Barbecue. 5th place, Pickin' Porkers. 4th place, Bubba Q. 3rd place, Chattahoochee Q. 2nd place, Uncle Kenny's Barbecue. 180 score, The Pit Crew Georgia. Somebody get this pin. Get this pin.
The first 180!
The pork category for pro. Q'n, stewin', and brewin'. Sauce BBQ. Old Plantation Barbecue. Midnight Burn. Contagious Q. Pirates of Pork Sense. Myron Nixon Smokers. Hot Wachulas. Moyer's Competition BBQ. Chattahoochee Q.
Smuggle me six.
Tenth place.
I can't hear you.
Old Plantation BBQ. Coming in ninth place, Myron Mixon Smokers. Coming in eighth place, Pirates of Porkson. Seventh place, Hewin, Stewin, and Brewin. Coming in sixth place, Moyer's Competition Barbecue Team. Coming in fifth place, Midnight Burn. And in fourth place, Contagious Q. Coming in third place, Chattahoochee Q. Coming in second place, Hot Wachulas. And obviously in first place, Sauced BBQ. The last category for the pro is beef brisket. Let me get the pit crew, Georgia. Jarvis Brothers BBQ. Hog Pound Smokers. Myron Mixon Smokers. Urban Q. Atlanta Barbecue Store. Sauced BBQ. Old Plantation BBQ. And Uncle Kenny's BBQ. Oh, and Contagious Q. Coming in 10th place, Myron Mixon Smokers. Coming in 9th place, Urban Q. Coming in 8th place, Atlanta Barbecue Store. Coming in 7th place, Jarvis Brothers BBQ. Coming in 6th place, The Pit Crew Georgia. In 5th place, Old Plantation Barbecue. In 4th place, Uncle Kenny's Barbecue. In 3rd place, Sauced BBQ. In 2nd place, Contagious Q. And with another perfect 180 score, Hog Pound Smokers. Congratulations to all those teams. Now the overall for pro teams. Atlanta Barbecue Store. Sauced BBQ. The Pit Crew Georgia. Bubba Q. Q'n', Stewin', and Brewin'. Moyer's Competition Barbecue Team. Chattahoochee Q. Contagious Q. Uncle Kenny's BBQ. Old Plantation Barbecue. I already see them. They're shaking in their boots right now, wondering what's going to happen. Coming in 10th place overall, Bubba Q. Coming in 9th place overall, Atlanta Barbecue Store. Coming in 8th place overall, Q'n', Stewin', and Brewin'. Coming in 7th place overall, Moyer's Competition Barbecue. Coming in 6th place overall, Old Plantation BBQ. coming in fifth place overall, Uncle Kenny's BBQ. Coming in fourth place overall, Pit Crew Georgia. Coming in third place overall, Contagious Q. Julie has all of the backyard results right here, front and center. And Cherie has pro right over here before we get to the last two. The winner has a 703 700 club pin. So second place, Chattahoochee Q. And your 2015 grand champion, Sauced. We gotta get Rachel to come up and hand this one out.
I know the winner's
And of course, the people's choice, I'm sure everybody's wondering who's won that. $250 prize. We be smoking.
Here we go, backyarder.
For all of the teams who have won in pro category from 10th place to first place in any of the categories, will you come over to the table where Mr. Sam Latimer is standing? He will get you your money. You will need to sign for the release of the cash. For any backyard teams, you will need to come over if you are in third or higher. So third, second, first in backyard in any of the three categories. Let's give one more round of applause for all of the teams and especially Rachel Wyatt. Oh yeah. Chris.
What about it?
Hey, stay down.